It's absolutely imperative that Google understands the things that you're putting on the website so it can present it to customers who are searching for your products. It's also important that your customers understand how to navigate through your website properly. What I'm going to do a very brief tutorial on today is how to use headers, which are identifiable bits of code. Don't worry, no coding involved for you. They'll help Google understand more about the page and also highlight important areas for your customers. I'm going to start by showing you a blog that is currently on my webpage, Google Digital Garage, my week at Google. Recently spent a week at Google head office. This bit here at the top, Google Digital Garage, my week at Google, is the H1. It's the title of the page. These will become more clear in a second, but it's the title. That is what the page is about. Whether it's a blog or whether it's a product, your title needs to contain that key information. So my week at Google was what I was focusing on, whereas you might be focusing on a particular product or a solution to a problem. That needs to be in your blog or your web page to identify to Google what it's all about. That's the title. It helps your customer and Google understand what you're going to be talking about. And then as we scroll through the copy, you'll see these highlighted areas here. Google Digital Garage Coach, Welcome to a Google Wonderland, Google's Cunning Plan. These are H2s. Again, don't worry about that for now. Subtitles. And if you are creating copy on your website, particularly if it's going to be longer format, there's going to be more text involved, what you really want to be doing is subtitle, paragraph, subtitle, paragraph. Break things up like that. It makes the content easy for your customer to read through and digest. No one wants to read a 1,000 word block of text. But if you break them up into nice short paragraphs with a very easily identifiable subheading or subtitle, it means that customers, as they're scanning through the web page, as they're scanning through the blog, can pick out the paragraphs and the information that's most important to them. And I'm just going to show you how to implement those on a web page. So what you have here is the back end of a typical WordPress website. These things might look slightly different depending on the platform you're building on, but they are generally quite recognisable. I've built web pages across a number of different platforms, and the language is pretty much the same. So what we got here at the top is add title. That's your H1. So just by typing in that box, you've created a piece of code that Google can recognize as a heading. And that's the first thing it will look at to understand what the page is all about. So you do want to make sure the key information, whether that's a product or the point you're trying to get across, is present in the title. This one is called, Are You Social Media Savvy? There we go, question mark. So the key information for me is social media savvy. I've done some research. It's a keyword that is used quite a lot. So hopefully the blog will get some attention once I've refined it and posted it. So are you social media savvy is the title. That's your H1. Only one title per page, but it happens simply by typing in the title page. Again, that is pretty much consistent across all of the different platforms that I've worked with over the last few years. So that's that. What I'm going to be doing is I've got a template-based builder. It's called Beaver Builder, and you may well have a drag-and-drop template builder yourself that looks quite similar. If I go into the Beaver Builder, it's going to take me to a page, and we can start constructing the blog. So, automatically, you can see here, Are You Social Media Savvy is at the top of the page. And that's going to be in the URL, so www.mybusiness.co.uk/are-you-social-media-savvy, that kind of thing. So that's at the top, already done. H1, Google looks at that and goes, title. I better look at the title to figure out what's going on. So I'm going to drop a text module into the box here. There we go. And I've pre-prepared some text. So I'm just going to copy that in now. And this is a blog that I was writing. I say it didn't work, I've abandoned it, I'm going to be using it for demonstration purposes here. And what we've got is a lot of text, as you can see. And if we have a look here, I've got an introductory paragraph, and then what does social media savvy mean? Now, you as a reader know or can figure out that that's a subtitle, because it's on its own, it's a statement, and then directly underneath it is a paragraph. Similarly with Making Staff Social Media Savvy, it's on its own, it's going to be a subtitle. So if you're scanning through the page as someone who's used to reading, you're going to pick those up. However, Google can't. Google is just going to see that as normal text. So you have to identify to Google that this is a subtitle, because Google will look at the title to get an understanding of what the page is about, and then it will start looking at the subtitles. And the subtitles will give it more information about the page, because generally you're going to put key information into your subtitles that Google can get its teeth into. And again, as your customer is reading through the article, those subheadings are going to take them on a journey. They're going to kind of help them understand what the page is about. And they might even be able to skip an entire paragraph and pop onto one that they're more interested in. Don't flatter yourself that your customers read every single word that you write on your website. They're generally scanning for key points. So this is how you do it. And it might work slightly different, but generally about the same. So I want to turn what does social media savvy mean into an identifiable subtitle for Google. And you do that through a code or a piece of coding. Again, you don't have to type a line of code. I'm going to highlight what I want to be a subtitle. So what does social media savvy mean? And if I go up here, I'm just going to scroll into it a little bit so you can see it better. You can see here, there's paragraph. Now that is generally called either paragraph or header. And if I give a little click on that, it opens up heading one, which is the title, don't use this, you've already done it, and then heading two. That's a subtitle. You may only be able to have one title for a page, but you can have as many different subtitles as you like. So that's the H2. And if I click on it, it's now turned that, I'll make it a bit smaller again, into a subtitle. And you can see, if you go back to the copy over here, it is now highlighted in blue. If you want to get fancy, you can go in and you can change the colour and the size of H2s, but that's not something I'm going to get into today. I also want to turn making staff social media savvy. In fact, I'm going to change a load here. So making staff social media savvy, that is one we want as a subtitle. So we go over there and we hit heading two. I'm going to scroll down, keeping to your brand, again, paragraph H2. And then, what was the last one? Good and bad examples of social media in the hands of staff. So again, paragraph heading two. So as we scroll through the copy again, you can now see that all of those stand out, which gives our customers a journey through the copy, but also tells Google to look at these to get some key information. You want to have your focus keyword, so social media savvy is what I'm focusing on. You want that in at least one of your subtitles. So if it is the name of a product, at least one of your subtitles needs to contain the product name again. Because Google goes, here's a title that contains these words, here's a subtitle that contains some of the same words. The title says social media savvy, one of the subtitles means social media savvy, perhaps the page is about social media savviness, and they can start building up their understanding it from there. And then in other headers, use related keywords or synonyms for the words that you're using. Google's clever enough to start picking those up and putting together a picture of what the page is about, so it can deliver it properly to your customers in a search. And again, your customers are scanning through these subtitles to pick out the bits that are of interest to them. So those are H1s and H2s. Now, if you have a little look here, I'll just zoom in a bit more again so you can see, you've got all the way down to H6. Now, to be honest, I wouldn't bother particularly. H1's automatically done for the title, and the H2s are probably as deep into this as you want to get, into your subtitles. But if you wanted to bullet point some information, or if you wanted to have some headings underneath a subheading or a subtitle, you might want to go to an H3, and I'll show you what I mean. So under keeping to your brand, I've got an introductory paragraph, which has some dreadful typos in it, but like I said, I was never going to publish this anyway. And then I've got some subheadings. So my subtitle is keeping to your brand, but I've got some subheadings. So to create a social media policy for your business is one of them. Now, I don't want that to be a massive subtitle. So what I can do here is I can then go to H3. And then this one, engage with staff, H3. Let's grab provide brand guidelines to ensure relevancy. Relevancy is your watchword, and anything you do on the internet, more relevant is to your customers, the more likely they are to engage with it. H3, and then have the last one here. So once again, we have indicated to Google that this is another important piece of information. So it could be a subheading like this, or it just could be bullet points. Now, if you've got a list of five bullet points generally have critical information. That's why you've bullet pointed them. Just make them an H3. So Google can go, ah, here's something else for me to look at. And how it looks on the page, we'll do that once again, is, we go up. Now you can see we've got the big one there and we've got some smaller ones picked out. And you might want to indent them slightly to the left or again, say, use bullet points or something like that to make them work. But that is a good way of structuring your content on your web page. A clear title that contains the keyword, the key information that you're looking for. Subtitles to divide up content to make it easier for your customers to read, but also subtitles that are set up and coded in the way we've done, so Google understands the flow of the page. And then if you do want to get into it, H3s to do subtopics underneath some of the subtitles. This way, lovely journey through your website and your web copy for your customers. A good understanding of Google of what the copy and the page is all about makes it much easier for Google and your customers to present this information and understand this information. But this structure is really useful, and Google looks at the title, the subtitles, any subheadings, so H3s, H4s, H5s, H6s if you're using them. And then it will look at the text that you've actually written to understand what the page is about. And the more specific and the more relevant each page can be, the easier it is for Google to present in searches to other people. I hope this tutorial has proved useful to you. If you've liked it and you're watching it on Facebook or LinkedIn, don't give it a like, give it a reaction. Give it a heart or a wow or something. That gives me a few more LinkedIn and Google points. Good thing to encourage your customers to do as well. And hit that share button to anyone who might find it useful. If you're watching on Twitter, please just give it a retweet. That'll be really useful as well. And if you're watching on YouTube, you can hit the like button, you can share it with people, and the subscribe button will be floating around on the screen just about now for you to click on to see more videos just like this. Thank you very much for watching. Have a fantastic day.